Hello everyone, I'm live. I'm just waiting for a few people to join up so I can begin talking. I hope all of you are doing well. Walaikum assalam. So I think some people have joined the live session, so I'll begin by introducing myself. I'm a fiction writer based in Pakistan, and so far I've written 4 books, alhamdulillah, and all of them have been published by Penguin India Random House. But with the 4th book, which is my latest book, we did an exception. Since there was a book ban between India and Pakistan due to some political differences between the two countries, we couldn't import my 4th book from India. So my publisher, Penguin India, got in touch with Liberty Publishing, and they published the book here in Pakistan for the Pakistani readers. Hello everyone, thank you for joining me. I hope all of you can watch me and hear me clearly. Please let me know if you guys face any audio or visual problems. So guys, this is my 4th book, my new book, The World Between Us. It was published in February, and Liberty Books got it out, I guess it was out in April, mid-April, yeah. So since then, the book is being sold in the Liberty Books. You can either buy the book online from the website, which I highly recommend during the current situation. But if you still feel like going out, then of course Liberty Books outlets have been opened and you can buy the book from there. I really hope all of you, not all of you, but most of you know me and have known or read my books. So do let me know which of my books you've read and which of my books you like the most, and what else would you like to see me writing. Irfan Haider Naqvi just said, literally madam, I'm currently reading this book. Thank you so much, Irfan. I hope you're having a great time while reading this book. First I'll talk about The World Between Us, and then I'll talk about my future projects, as well as and then we'll take some questions from all of you. We'll do a quick Q&A session in the end. So The World Between Us is basically about two people, Amal and Kais, and they both belong to two different worlds, and they have two different and contrasting personalities. Kais belongs to an elite family, whereas Amal comes from a middle class background, and both of them, it's Ubaidullah Khan, it's The World Between Us is an office romance. Essentially, it's an office romance, but I've also explored serious topics and serious and sensitive topics like depression and mental health in this book. So yeah, I was talking about the two main leads of this book, Hoor Ehsan, Love the World Between Us. It's light yet super engrossing. Please keep writing such sweet romance novels. Thank you so much, Hoor. Thank you so much for appreciating my work. Thank you so much for appreciating this book. So those of you who do not know about this book, I was telling about the main characters. So Amal and Kais are the main characters of this book, and both of them happened to meet briefly on Tinder, on a dating app, and then they both interact briefly, and then they come across each other in an office environment. Both of them work in the same office, and that's how their story is progressed. Interestingly, there's a twist in the book, and the twist somehow relates to both of them, and they both are linked together with the past, and how that past is unfolded, and what really connects them and binds them together is what this book is all about. So I hope those of you who haven't read the book, please visit Liberty Books and get your hands on it as soon as possible. Muneeb Alam says, there is a thing about our story ends here, but I want to know the story behind this book. What do you want to know, Muneeb, about our story ends here? Let me know whenever you, whatever you want to know. And Saim Zahid asks, will you always write romance? To be very honest, Saim, I think I find myself more comfortable while I'm writing romance. But I don't think I will always be writing romance. It could be, but yeah, but whatever I choose to write, it will always be linked with romance. I mean, you just pick up any book. It could be about any subject and you will find this genre somewhere inside the plot between any of the characters. So I'll briefly talk about my upcoming book. My upcoming book, it's a psychological romance. Again, there's romance in it, but it's also a psychological thriller. I would classify it as psychological thriller romance. I've always wanted to write a psychological thriller. It's very interesting. It literally gives me goosebumps whenever I'm writing it. During Ramadan, I was writing it in a very good speed, and because we were working from home, I was working from home due to pandemic, so I had a lot of time to work on this book. But unfortunately, I had to go through a rough patch in my life, so I stopped. So I stopped working on the book for a little period. But again, I'm thinking to go back to my writing mode and finish the first draft of the book so I can bring that book to you as soon as possible. So, Kurutulen Kamran is asking about the price of this book. Well, if you get it from Liberty Books, then you'll get it for $7.95. And if you want a signed copy, you can always get in touch with me on social media. You can send me a DM on Instagram or Facebook and I can arrange a signed copy for you. I have sent signed copies of this book to many of my readers who specifically requested for it. And if you want a signed copy of The World Between Us, just ping me, send me a DM, let me know and I'll arrange one for you. Maria Rizwan said that she has read all of my four books. Thank you so much, Maria. Let me know which one did you like the most and why did you like that book most. Do tell me. Muneeb Alam, from where the idea come from? I meant that's a unique idea because I meant just take too much time finding classic story ends. One of them. Thank you, Muneeb. Thank you for finding our story ends here really unique. Most of the readers do not know that our story ends here is really close to my heart, and if someone asked me to pick one favorite book from my four books, then I would definitely choose our story ends here, because I haven't gotten myself attached or connected to that extent the way I connected with my characters in our story ends here. I don't know, there's something very odd about them and I'm oddly connected to them, and I still feel connected to them. Even today, if you ask me about my favorite characters or my favorite book, I definitely choose our story ends here. I choose Sarmadin Meher over any other characters. So I think I'm getting a couple of questions from the readers. Bina Shah, hi Bina, how does your hair look so good in lockdown? I don't know. I think I just had a wash. Thank you. Even though it wasn't a relevant question, but still thank you. Yasir, I also want to write a book. Can you give me some ideas? Yasir, I hardly have ideas for my own books. So even if I get an idea, I don't think I would like to share it with anyone. I would jump on an idea and start writing it myself. So if you want to write a book, then you have to generate that idea. You have to construct something and write something. Yasir Khan Niazi, what's your past books, man? So far, Yasir, I've written four books. I have all of them near me. This first one was Undying Affinity. The second one was Our Story Ends Here. And the third one was All of My Heart, and fourth book is The World Between Us. Shokat Lohar says, good work, our story ends here, let's try this The World Between Us. Yeah, Shokat, please definitely do read The World Between Us and do let me know what you think about it. Because for an author, hearing good reviews about your book from readers is everything that we can ever ask for. Tanya Ali, hey, just joined. Can you please tell me the age group suitable to be the reader of your book, especially this one? I think teens can read this one. Teenagers can definitely read my books. And I would say that they can be categorized somewhere between young adult or new adult. Yeah. So I think children below the age of 13 or 14, I wouldn't recommend them reading my books. Irfan Haider Naqvi, how about the next book, Madam, in progress? Yes, Irfan, my upcoming book is already in progress. Due to some personal reasons, I couldn't work on it. But I'm definitely going to resume writing my book. And hopefully, I'll try my best that the first draft of, you know, I'm able to complete the first draft by the end of summers, and hopefully it can come out by the end of this year or early next year, inshallah. Maria Rizwan, even after reading all four, have not been able to pinpoint what is it, but there is something definitely. Are you talking about my books, Maria? Okay, I hope you enjoyed reading them, and because I have heard most of my readers say that they find my books very light-hearted, and you know, it's like a fresh breeze. My books are like a fresh breeze for them, and they enjoy reading whenever they're reading it because they're very light-hearted and they can be read easily, and there's no okay. Thank you for Siha Bilal Ahmed. But what about your inspiration for writings? Well, I think I am inspired by every little thing around me. It could be about anything. I can derive the inspiration from anything around which is around me. It could be a song. It could be music. It could be a scene from a movie or from a book. It could be a character from a movie or a book. So it can be anything, and I'll just watch that character or watch that setting or the scene and then get inspired from it and then start writing about it. So inspiration can come from anything and from anyone. Meher Ali, are all of your four books connected to each other? No, Meher, they are not connected at all. They are all standalone books and they can be read separately. All of the books have separate stories, separate plots, and they're not connected to each other at all. Zainab Bajwa, your favorite book out of the four? Zainab, my favorite book is, like I said earlier, it is Our Story Ends Here, hands down. Abdullah Dayo, hello, assalamu alaikum. Ma'am, we had a chat on Twitter. At that time, you were not famous and looking for publisher. Now, happy to see you after a long time. Hope your sister is fine as well. Thank you so much, Abdullah. Thank you so much. During 2012 and 13, yes, I was struggling. I was struggling to find a publisher. And it was a very, very tough period for me. And I still remember it. And I'm grateful that I got to experience that time, that struggle. Because of that time, I'm able to be where I am today. So thank you so much. Muneeb Alam, I was planning to come to Karachi for my book launch of The World Between Us, but I couldn't. Obviously, coronavirus happened to all of us and I couldn't travel. So all of my plans regarding the book launch and book promotions went down the hill. So inshallah, future may, whenever I get a chance, I'll definitely visit Karachi and visit all of my fans and readers who are based in Karachi, inshallah, very soon. Amir Rahman, Adab, I like Our Story Ends Here the most, likely to be in the list of those books who have read all four very soon. Thank you so much, Amir. Thank you so much. I hope you get to read my remaining books as well. Thank you so much. Bilal Ahmed, I mean, writing is an inbuilt capacity or can be learned to write? Of course, no, it's not something that's I know it's for most writers, writing is God gifted, and it's an inbuilt talent as well. But still, you can learn to write, you can become a writer, and it's not that difficult. You just need to have that determination. You just need to have the motivation to become a writer. Umair Ahmed, I recently found you on Liberty Books and I've ordered your recent and my first book, The World Between Us, and I'm so anxiously waiting to reading your book. Thank you so much, Umair. I hope you enjoy reading my book, and do let me know what you thought about. I would be waiting for your response. Maria Rizwan, please write for young to mature adults, romance only. You are too good. Your plot writing just pulls across the reader. This is the something. Thank you so much, Maria. I think I've already written books for mature people, so mature readers even can read my books, and I think they all fall in the category of new adult. So yeah, they can read adult readers can definitely read my books. So guys, do you have any questions? If you have any questions for me, anything, just write them down and I'll try my best to answer them as much as I can. If you have any questions regarding writing, regarding publishing or anything, just send me your questions. Right now I can see that 71 people are watching this video right now. So we'll do a quick Q&A session, and if you have any questions for me, then just write them down and I'll answer them. Bilal Ahmed, why our society not having habit of reading? I don't know. This is a problem with us. Our readership is very low as compared to other countries, and I don't know. People should be encouraged to read, because I think reading is a habit that needs to be cultivated in young children. When kids need to read a lot, and this habit should be cultivated in them when they are young. So when we have more readers, definitely our readership will increase, and more books will be sold, and we'll have more writers, Pakistani writers, I mean. Okay. We have a couple of questions. Bilal Mirza, is Liberty Books also publishing books? Yes, Bilal, Liberty Books has recently ventured into publishing, and my fourth book, The World Between Us, has been published by Liberty Publishing. They're doing an incredible job, and you should definitely consider them when you are going to find a publisher in Pakistan. Jilani Alina, I love your books. Keep it up, Sara. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Jilani. Mahmoodul Hassan, do you mind with a character in mind or a social? Do you write with a character in mind or a social? I've never really given much thought to it. A character is just formed in my mind, and once it's there, I start writing about it and I start building a story around that character. Hasnain Hanif, your favorite writer except yourself? I have a lot of favorite writers, but if I talk about romance, then it's definitely Colleen Hoover. I have heard most of the readers telling me that they find me as they see Colleen Hoover, and they feel like my writing resembles her, or there's a similarity between our writing. But whatever it is, I take those comments as compliments, and because I really love her work. Other than that, Colleen, I love reading Cecilia Ahern, I love reading Paulo Coelho, there's Khalid Hosseini, there's Faiqa Mansur, there's so many writers whose work I admire. So yeah, there are a lot of writers who have impressed me with their works. Shokas Lohar, what is your experience as being a writer in Pakistan, especially in fiction, while publisher do not give easy debut to new writers writing? I know being a writer in Pakistan, it's not easy, especially if you are starting out as a new writer. and but I believe that your work needs to be that polished. It needs to be so much good that, you know, even publishers cannot reject you. Your manuscript, your book, it needs to be strong enough for people to like it, and strong enough for publishers to notice your work. So it might be difficult in the beginning, but once you're there, once you get a good publisher in your hands, then half of the job is made easier. Hi Muniba, what are the challenges faced by authors in Pakistan when publishing a book? First of all, they can't find a publisher in Pakistan. Many newbie writers come to me and they ask me where did I got my book published and how do they find a publisher in Pakistan. I've also made a video on YouTube where I've tried to guide the newbie, the budding writers, about how they can publish their books in Pakistan. So finding a right publisher is one of the challenges that most of the emerging writers face in Pakistan. But once you find a good publisher, there's no going back. Liberty Publishing is already doing an incredible job, and you should definitely, the new writers should definitely check them out and get help from them. Instead of going somewhere else, instead of finding a literary agent in abroad or in India, if you have good publishing companies in Pakistan, then you should definitely consider them first. Zainab Bajwa, love your books. And also, how old were you when you wrote your first book, Undying Affinity? I think, Zainab, I was, when I started writing Undying Affinity, I don't know how age really matters when you're writing something, but I think I was 23 or 24 when I started writing Undying Affinity. So yeah, I wasn't much younger. Meher Ali, I'm excited to read Madam, your books. I will order soon, but I have a question. Are your books, they related to your personal life, author's personal experiences? Please tell me. No, Meher, my books are not related to my personal life at all. They're all fiction completely. They're all made up stories completely. They're fictionalized, and nothing has been inspired from my real life. So yeah. Mehran Tunyu, I'm new here, but after listening this, I shall to devour your books as early as possible. Thanks for this video. Thank you so much, Mehran. I hope you enjoy reading my books. Zainab Zaidi, when is the new series of books coming up? New series, do you mean my new book? I'm already working on my fifth book, and inshallah, hope it comes out really soon. Zainab Zaidi, love your books. Thank you so much, Zainab. Thank you so much. Farooq Naveed, how was your experience with Liberty Publishing? My experience was with Liberty Publishing was definitely very good, and the only problem that I faced was that I was told my book would release around Valentine's Day, around the same day as it was being published in India, but it couldn't release because there was some problem with the printers, and as they were delaying the work. Other than that, I'm completely satisfied with the way they have published my books. They have marketed my books on social media and everywhere. So yeah, I'm really, really happy with the experience. And if I get a chance again with publishing them, so I'll definitely go with them again. Manzoor Ali, I don't ask questions because my same questions as Maria is one. This is my hearty question. Acha, Zainab Zaidi, how many new books we shall wait from you? Love from what you write. Zainab, I'll be coming up with my new book, inshallah, very, very soon. Maybe by the end of the year or early next year. I hope I can finish it soon. Afira Khawla, I hope I'm pronouncing your name right. When did you first realize that you wanted to be a writer? I think the moment I started enjoying writing. That was the moment. When I realized that I should become a writer, I started writing fan fictions, and that's where I found my growing interest in this process, and I really started enjoying what I was doing. So yeah, from that moment onwards, I realized that I wanted to become a writer. Yasir Wahid, who is your inspiration and what inspires you to write? I don't have a particular inspiration, to be very honest, and I think any it just needs to click something in my mind. It just I just need to be you know, I just need to come across anything that inspires me, that interests me, that picks my mind. And anything can be a source of inspiration for me. It could be a character from a movie or a book, it could be a song, or it could be a scene from a movie, anything. So yeah, as far as my inspirations is concerned, it can be from anything. And music really inspires me to write. When I'm listening to music, I tend to write better. That's what I feel. So guys, I think I'm slowly coming towards the end of this live session. It was a wonderful session with all of you, and I would like to thank Liberty Books for giving me an opportunity to be on their platform and interact with all of you. And I know most of you haven't read my books, and they haven't even known about me. So after this live session, I hope you can visit Liberty Books or visit their website and order my books. And if you're into romance, and or if you want to lead something lighthearted, something breezy, something really light and heart touching, then I would definitely recommend you reading my books. So if you read them, you'll find out that how they can take you to somewhere else. You can escape the reality for a while and go into a world of dreams. So yeah, I would urge you all to read my books, and when you read them, do give me your feedback, and I'll be really, really looking forward to reading your reviews. And so thank you so much. Thank you so much, Liberty Books, and thank you to each one of you who joined this session and became a part of it. Let me just quickly go through. There are a few more questions that I've actually missed. Umair Ahmed asks, if someone wants to publish a book, I mean poetry in my case, so what is the requirement of a publisher, or how the book is published? If you're into poetry and you want to submit a poetry book, then you should definitely get in touch with the publisher. I think they'll give you a basic guideline, and they'll guide you better in how they are really publishing poetry. Manzoor Ali, my book is for $7.95 if you buy from Liberty Books. Yeah. Fasiha Zareen, my kids in their initial days, I didn't want them to sit and read anything. I think Fasiha, if they're 10 or 11 years old, you should ask them to read all dark books. You should tell them to read Harry Potter, or they should be reading something from Enid Blyton. Bilal Mirza, are they also publishing simultaneously in India? Yes, all of my books have been published by India, and all of them are available there as well. Thank you, Meher. Thank you for joining in. Muhammad Nasir Jahan, how much is writer financial rewards as royalty of books you get? To be very honest, Nasir, royalties are not enough for you to make a living. For to be a writer, you cannot simply rely on the royalties or the advance you get from your books. Writing rarely pays your bills, so you have to keep another profession in the side. Munivalam, why don't we see fairy tales in Pakistan writing? I think it's one of our specialty in the 19th and 20th century. I think we lack fantasy writers in Pakistan. Yeah, we don't have much. I don't know of any writer who has written fantasy. It's a very, very interesting genre and should be explored by writers. So thank you so much, guys. I am going offline, and thank you for joining the session and making it so much interesting with your questions. Inshallah, we'll meet soon. We'll talk soon. And until then, keep yourself safe. Stay safe. Stay inside your homes. Protect yourself from the coronavirus as much as you can. Keep yourself safe. Keep your family safe. And I wish you all the best. And please, please, please do read my book, my new book, The World Between Us, and get it from Liberty Books. Thank you so much, guys. I wish you all a wonderful, wonderful day. Allah Hafiz.